My name is Trevor Hyde. I've been skateboarding since the sixth grade, and I'm still doing it. Growing up skateboarding, that's like all I did as a kid. I mean, skateboarding was everything to me. I lived it, I breathed it, I sweat it, I bled it. I even ate skateboarding. Like, I did it a lot. It was everything I loved to do, and I had a lot of fun doing it, and it kept me out of trouble. But it also put me in trouble a couple times, like a little bit. But mainly it was really fun. And with skateboarding, a lot of non-fun things come with it and a lot of negative vibes come out of it and stuff. I grew up in the skateboard scene and in the hardcore music scene. And with both of those things kind of come some bad things. Like with skateboarding, I was surrounded by a lot of... I didn't really have any Christian influences my age. I had like... A lot of my friends, like half the majority of my friends were potheads, or some of them were even drug dealers, and they would, a lot of times I'd have some friends that would break in into places just to get their fix and stuff like that. And with stuff like skateboarding, it brings crazy things, like crazy weird girls and stuff. And sometimes girls would come to the park just to kind of find a dude to get with, and that was kind of it. And in the streets it was no different. One time I was street skating and a group of girls came up in a car and actually tried to like physically fight me into a car, and that was kind of crazy. And so it just comes with its ups and downs. And the atmosphere, the hardcore scene was no different as well. It was kind of like surrounded by hardcore crews and dudes that just loved to fight. They took their rage and anger out on fighting and beating people up, and a lot of people get jumped in the scene and stuff. And I've had my share of being jumped, and it just comes a lot of negative things. Growing up as a Christian, I was the only kid I knew around my age that was a Christian. I had always growing up, I was a Christian ever since I can remember. And every time I had the opportunity to say that prayer to accept God into my life, I did it, and I did it by faith. It's just that I never really, growing up as the only person I knew as a Christian my age, it was kind of hard for me to stand for the Lord. I felt like kind of like a one-man stand. So with that, I kind of, at one point around the eighth grade, I went to my family camp, which was like, once out of every year we went to family camp, and it lasted a week, and that was one time I got to see other Christians. And there was a dude that spoke with crazy passion, and he spoke specifically on standing firm in the faith and being strong in Christ and living for him, and you know, witnessing, telling others about him boldly and living out the word of God. And that dude, he spoke out of like Romans 12, where it says, do not any longer conform to the patterns of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. And when he spoke on that, God sparked something in my heart, and the Holy Spirit moved, and like I just was transformed. I exploded. Like I went to school, and I started like writing scripture on my t-shirts, and I was a crazy kid. I would like run into things just to get people's attention and tell them Jesus loved them. Like I did whatever it was in my power to share the love of Christ. And at the skate park, I would write scripture on my skateboard, and I would tell others about the Lord at the skate park, or even in the streets sometimes. And in the hardcore scene and the shows and stuff, I just exploded. I started doing crazy things, and I actually put myself in danger. And I found myself breaking up fights, and actually a couple times when dudes would get jumped, I would just find myself jumping over random strangers and just hugging over them and letting all these other dudes kick me and punch me instead of them, and kind of protect a complete stranger. I knew that's what Christ did for me, so that's what I wanted to do for others. And I wanted to shine the love of Christ. And God had he had totally taken me, and he had transformed me. He had erupted in every part of my being to where I'm this new creature. I have so much hope, and he has brought me through so much. And when I actually realized that God had done that to a simple kid like me, through an average dude like me, just a young little kid like me, through one man, through one guy that was willing to obey and say, I will speak your word and I will do it wholeheartedly with passion, that immediately sparked my interest to be a speaker for God. And so with that, I've just continued to speak, and I have done it throughout my college years. And through that, I have learned the gifts that God has given me, like skateboarding and beatboxing. Beatboxing came out of nowhere. And with these two things, people will come, and I can do shows for both of them, and people will come and they'll watch or they'll listen. And when they come, they'll see or they'll hear things I can do with my body, and they'll respect that, and they gain the respect, and they actually listen, and they'll allow me to say some things about the Lord, and I've grown to speak through those things. And speaking is one of the things that I love to do the most for the Lord. I love to skateboard for God. I just give myself wholeheartedly to Him, and God has truly taken over my life, and I like it that way. The best thing Jesus Christ has done for me is He has taught me how to stay true to myself by staying true to Him.